गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, आई एम सी के झा, योर टीचर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश। टुडे द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास सिक्स, यू विल लर्न अबाउट इन योर इंग्लिश ग्रामर द टॉपिक एडवर्ब। टुडेज टॉपिक इज एडवर्ब ऑफ क्लास सिक्स स्टूडेंट्स। ओके, so very first we must know about adverb. What is an adverb? How can we define adverb? To define adverbs, we must know that an adverb can modify verb, adjectives, another adverbs, and even sometimes the complete sentence. In other words, you can say ki adverbs are words that usually modify verbs, adjectives, other adverbs and complete sentences. They aid, adverbs aid something to the meaning of the verb, the adjective, or the adverb or a complete sentence. Just like an adjective that aids to the meaning of the noun or pronoun. So what are the main points here to learn? The main points: the word which can modify a verb, an adjective, another adverb, or a complete sentence, the word is adverb. And modifying an adjective, a verb, another adverb, or a sentence, it aids something to the meaning of the verb, meaning of the another adverb, meaning of the adjectives, or meaning of the sentence. To understand it, you have some example here. He dances gracefully. He dances gracefully. The word gracefully is an adverb because it aids the meaning of the verb dance. How he dances, the answer is gracefully. Like this, the sentence: Sheila is very talkative. Sheila is very talkative. So where the word very, how much talkative she is, the answer is very, very gracefully. So the word very is adverb. So like this, an adverb can modify a verb, as you have seen in this example, he dances gracefully. Here gracefully modifies the verb dances. When he say कि ही इज वेरी इंटेलिजेंट, सो इन दिस एग्जाम्पल द वर्ड वेरी मॉडिफाइज द वर्ड इंटेलिजेंट, एंड इंटेलिजेंट इज एन एडजेक्टिव, हाउ मच इंटेलिजेंट, सो द एडजेक्टिव इंटेलिजेंट इज मॉडिफाइज बाय द वर्ड वेरी, देयरफॉर वेरी इज एन एडवर्ब. व्हेन यू से कि फॉर्चुनेटली he came in time, in this sentence you can see the word fortunately. It is an adverb because it modify whole the sentence, he came in time. Okay, so like this. So remember four things: point 1 verb, point 2 adjective, point 3 another adverb, point 4 complete sentence. One side, the other side, the word which can modify दीज फोर्स मे बी वर्ब मे बी एडजेक्टिव मे बी अनदर एडवर्ब मे बी कंप्लीट सेंटेंस सो ऑल फोर कैन बी मॉडिफाइड बाय एन एडवर्ब हैव यू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द एडवर्ब व्हाट इज एडवर्ब व्हाट इट डज यस इट इज वेरी क्लियर टू यू नाउ यू हैव टू गो ऑन kinds of adverbs so broadly there are six kinds of adverbs broadly six kinds of adverbs number 1 adverbs of manner this kind of adverbs tell us how or in what manner the adverb which tells us about manner is adverb of manner to understand it you have an example she debates confidently okay so the word confidently shows the manner number 2 adverb of place these indicate the place of an action kind of adverb number 2 adverb of place indicate the place of an action where the action is done okay Varun is playing outside in this sentence the word outside indicates to the place where Varun is playing the answer is outside so it indicates towards the place this is number 2 adverb kind number 3 adverb of time tells us about the time of action when the action is done they arrived today in this sentence you can see ki today indicates time when he came today indicates towards time and number 3 adverb of frequency These tell us how frequently or how often action takes place. Adverb of frequency tells us how frequently or how often an action takes place. She never allows us to talk in the class. In this example, you can see that the word never is used. Never indicates the frequency okay number 5 adverb of degree these tell us about the intensity of an action adverb of degree tells us about the intensity of an action what is the intensity of an action is denoted by adverb of degree the tea is too hot in this example you can see the word too it shows us the intensity of the things okay and the last number is interrogative adverbs last kind of adverb is interrogative adverb these are used for asking questions and use such words as who where how why whom whose etc okay so where are my shoes in this example you can see the word where is used and what the word where does here He asked a question. The speaker wants to know about the place. Therefore, he asked, where is my shoes? Okay. You can see the next example. Why did you tell her about the picnic? So, in this example, you can see the word why. Why is used? For what? Why is used to ask a question? To know the reason, to know the cause. Where we use interrogative sentence? Why we use interrogative sentence, or what is an interrogative sentence? If you want to know, I think you have already studied it in your previous classes. The sentence which is used to ask or know something is an interrogative sentence. And interrogative sentence can start with two types. One, with an auxiliary verb or with a question word. When we ask a question with auxiliary verb, it can answer yes or no only. Okay, but on the other hand, we have WH question. WH, because all the question words of English have the combination of W and H. So, we start that second type of questions with the question word. Question word means WH, okay? So, each and every question word has its particular requirement. Suppose, a question starts with who. The question word who requires person. The answer must be a person. If a question starts with who, we have to answer about a person. What? What requires fact? The answer of the what must be fact. Whenever you are asked by someone, what is your name? What would you like to say? You say, na, ki my name is X, Y or Z. That is fact. Okay. Suppose a question starts with why. The question word why requires reason or cause. When requires time, where requires place, how requires manner. Each and every particular question word has its particular requirement. We have to answer according to the particular requirement of the particular question word. Then it will be correct, otherwise not. You can't answer in yes or no in such a way. But on the other hand, as I have said you, auxiliary verbs can be used to start a question. But there we only find the answer yes or no. We can't find out the reason, we can't out the place, we can't out the time, we can't out the region, etc. Therefore, we have to start with question word, that is WH combination, so that they are known as WH questions. Okay. Now, you must know about the position of adverbs in a sentence. The position of an adverb, where we can use. So, adverb of manner, adverb of place, adverb of time, all three. Adverb of manner, adverb of place, adverb of time. Usually placed after the verb in a sentence. All three, remember that. Adverb of manner, adverb of time, adverb of place. These three adverbs is usually used in a sentence after verb. Okay, he runs fast. So in this sentence you can see that the adverb fast is used after the verb runs. Okay, so नोट दिस पॉइंट इन योर कॉपी कि पोजिशन ऑफ एडवर्ब, नंबर वन एडवर्ब ऑफ माइनर, नंबर टू एडवर्ब ऑफ प्लेस, नंबर थ्री एडवर्ब ऑफ टाइम मस्ट बी यूज आफ्टर ए वर्ब. नेक्स्ट एडवर्ब ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी, एडवर्ब ऑफ डिग्री, दीज टू एडवर्ब्स आइदर फ्रीक्वेंसी और डिग्री यूजली यूज बिटवीन सब्जेक्ट एंड वर्ब. एडवर्ब ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड एडवर्ब ऑफ डिग्री यूजली यूज इन बिटवीन सब्जेक्ट एंड वर्ब. सो स्टूडेंट टूडे यू लर्न द डेफिनेशन ऑफ एडवर्ब्स, वॉट इज एन एडवर्ब्स, नंबर टू काइंड्स ऑफ एडवर्ब्स, वॉट आर दे, वॉट दे डू एंड द पोजिशन ऑफ एडवर्ब, वेयर वी कैन यूज पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ एडवर्ब्स इन अ सेंटेंस. ओके, इट्स ऑल अबाउट एडवर्ब एंड यू विल लर्न मोर अबाउट दिस इन योर नेक्स्ट क्लासेस. सो नोट डाउन ऑल दोज थिंग्स इन योर कॉपी एंड ट्राई टू रिमेंबर दैट वन. ओके, सो थैंक यू.